Hey everyone, it's time to continue with the series I began back in December. This series is all about the Ghostbusters. These videos will be in support of our History and Origins videos, but they'll be shorter and more specific to a particular detail or revelation. So without further ado, let's begin. In the Ghostbusters, the supernatural spectacular novelization, and by extent, the new Ghostbusters, the original novelization of Ghostbusters 1 and 2 Omnibus, many things are revealed that didn't quite make it into the final cut of the film, while other things were completely erased or slightly altered. It's always been suspected that either Ray or Peter designed the No Ghost logo, which became the Ghostbusters symbol. However, according to the novelization, it was actually Janine Melnitz. You see, Janine was sent to the Ghostbusters via an employment agency. The following is an excerpt from the novelization. Janine Melnitz picked her way around the scaffolding and peered into the garage bay. A line of makeshift work lights were strung from the ceiling so that the carpenters, who were laying the new floorboards, could see to work. She gingerly stepped up to a hairy young man who was wrestling with an immense power cable.
"Excuse me, do you work here?"
He pushed back his hard hat. His eyes were rimmed with grime.
"Lady, does this look like relaxation?"
Janine decided that she didn't like him at all.
"Don't get smart, fella. I mean, do you work for the Ghostbusters?"
"Nah, I work for Con Ed. You want those nuts in the back."
"Thanks, I think."
Peter Venkman was standing in a cleared area, giving instructions to a team of painters. He was amazed that there had turned out to be so much to do, and even more amazed that it looked like it was actually getting done. He himself had not worked so hard in years. Private industry. At least in the university system, you could get the grad students to do everything. But here, the work was your own. Of course the profits were too. He still had a few misgivings, but they were rapidly fading. There wasn't room for them. All available space was becoming filled with electrical equipment. Protective clothing, sensors, storage batteries, bins, boxes, cartons, crates, containments. Used to be, I didn't worry because I didn't care. Now, I don't have time to worry. A shower of blue sparks rained down from above, and the men ducked protectively.
"Egon!"
"Sorry."
Bankman brushed himself off, and then noticed a young woman crouching fearfully against the wall, looking up at the ceiling.
"Miss, are you all right?"
She looked at him, big eyes, red hair, thick glasses, and when she spoke, a queen's accent.
"I'm not sure. Is that going to happen again?"
"Probably, but it's harmless. Can I help you?"
"I hope so. The agency sent me over.
Janine Melnitz. Dr. Peter Venkman. How soon can you start?" She looked around at the chaos. Somewhere in the building, a circuit breaker blew with a deafening snap, and all of the lights went out.
"The question is, how soon can you?"
Venkman watched them hang the sign over the garage doorway. Ghostbusters, with their new logo, a cartoon ghost encircled by the red international sign for Prohibition. Pretty good. The logo had been Janine's idea. So far, the woman was working out. She hadn't yet asked to be paid. You can find this excerpt in Chapter 4 on pages 42 and 43 in the new Ghostbusters Omnibus, and in the original Ghostbusters The Supernatural Spectacular in Chapter 4 on pages 55 and 56, copyright 1985. There's another scene in the novelization that talks about one of the commercials the Ghostbusters filmed, which was much different than the one that appeared in the film, but is quite similar to the one that appeared in Ghostbusters 2. Janine starred in both. So what do you guys think about the explanation of how Janine came into the employment of the Ghostbusters and how the team came into the concept of their logo? Personally, I like the explanation, as it makes sense in the realm of the franchise and the characteristics of the main characters. It shows that Janine from the very beginning wasn't just the receptionist and office manager, but that she had a hand in the development of the Ghostbusters as a whole. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. If you enjoyed that video, make sure you hit the subscribe button right there so you stay up to date on all things geek culture. Also, go ahead and check out one of these two playlists on the side for more videos just like the one you just watched. I'm Shannon from Comicgeddon TV, the only place on YouTube where all geek culture collides. Take care, geeks.